So welcome back to my channel, and today I'll be playing Dyrroth again, the third gameplay here. First of all, we will look after what skills Dyrroth have, and he's saying that I can do what I want to. So we will look after what skills Dyrroth have. First of all, here is the model. Then comes the burst strike. The first skill, he releases the burst strike. The main thing is burst strike has longer range when abyss enhanced. And what is abyss enhanced? I'll tell you later about it. Second skill, spectre step, and fatal strike will deal 150 of original damage. Wow. And slow the target by 90% and reduce 75%, means target defense can go into negative also. And here is the wrath of the abyss, the passive. That's what burst strike and spectre is. They both get enhanced when his passive is on his way, and it happens because of the cooldown which he gets whenever he puts his basic attack on while his passive is on. So we'll be seeing what Dyrroth is up to first, builds and emblems. So I have told in my earlier videos that I would be playing him someday with Wings of Apocalypse Queen, and today the builds I'm giving you is the normal one, but in the game I'll be changing builds a lot because of many lifesteal heroes and enemies, so I'll be changing it accordingly. So let's get to the gameplay without any delay, and you can look after for yourself what enemies we have. We have here Dyrroth, we have this Bedeng, Hanzo, Sun and Vexana. So there is enough of lifesteal, so I would be changing the builds so that I can get enough of damage as well as sustain as well as get away in harder conditions. And so let's start it. So here it is. And Dyrroth is a good hero to play, to be honest, treating as a fighter but playing it with assassin emblem because I like it. Playing with assassin emblem, I told you guys that with assassin emblem Dyrroth is so up because that extra penetration he gets is the best thing ever. And to be honest, Dyrroth is a very fun hero to play. You will see what is abyss enhanced. I'll be telling you guys about it when this abyss enhanced state comes. I'll tell you guys about it. Here is the sun, enemy sun coming up, and you can look the bar over below the HP bar of Dyrroth is being filled slowly, but since I'll be using jungle item for faster jungling, so it would be filling very fast enough. So that's how it would be, that I should be using jungle item, tier 2 jungle item, nimble blade, to enhance my attack on jungle monsters. So here's the red bar, and that's what we called abyss enhanced. Here the sun attacking on me, useless because he can't kill me with this. I'm having an edge over it because I have blink skill as well as the defense decrease, which is the most powerful thing of Dyrroth. So here's the combo again, the second skill, the first skill, and then again the second skill. And here he has done very bad thing, you know, attacking me. I have put my combo, second skill, first skill, and then sun is useless. His defense would be reduced to around 25 from 100, so he gone for nothing. Give me the first blood easily and crab also. You know, now I'm ahead of the farm, and since if a fighter in a game is ahead of farm than enemies, then you know how dangerous it can be. And with assassin set, I'll be farming very fast because the go. So the talent I'll be using is bounty hunter. I'll be targeting turret here, so get an enough edge over the enemies so that they would be busy in laning and I will be busy in their farming. I should be eating up their jungle also sometimes. But here is the thing, I destroyed the turret first and then destroying the sun again, but he just put his doppelganger and left. Again he's up to me. Now I will kill him for sure. I think that I can, maybe I don't know, Yes, yes, he came again. No, it is his doppelganger actually. And yeah, so our minions are inside. Maybe I can do a combo. I'll try for it. I'll go for it. Maybe yes, I'll be going for it. Yeah, here it is. Yeah, look at the position and the damage it gives. You know, it gives enough damage equal to an 80% of enemy's lost HP. Sun has lost enough of his HP to be damaged by my attack and to be killed by it. So that's how his ult works, the destruction. First of all, we should be focusing on jungling, because that's how we should be going. And again, I'm on the jungle monster, same combo. First decrease the defense, that will increase the attack on any of jungle creep and enemy hero. This second skill doesn't work on minions, it just works on creeps, even as turtle, on turtle, but not on lord. I have checked that, maybe you can see that also in game. Now here it is, I got the free kill of Vexana from just second skill first step, and here I will try to kill enemy Dyrroth. Oh, he's just escaped. Okay, I got him. I just got him with the second phase of my second skill, and I got him because his Dyrroth ult takes time to charge. He was charging the ult unless until I gave him enough of the damage so that he died. Now I'm with the crab, I'm with the highest farm here, and my first item is coming up, which is Demon Hunter Sword, which would be giving me the lifesteal to be one on one with any hero. Now I have got the Hanzo's body, let's see what happens with it. Yeah, again I'm doing the same thing. Maybe Hanzo will escape or not. Maybe he will, no, he can't. He will die. Yeah, because of extra penetration this assassin emblem set gives, this would be so easy for me to kill heroes like Hanzo, Vexana, and even Dyrroth also. I'll kill one on one in later game. And here, oh my god, I think I got cornered. No, I just escaped. Okay, so there's a gank going on, we'll see. Maybe Ozilong is in the dead zone. Okay, wait, I think I'm in the dead zone. Okay, I'm fighting Sun here, gave him enough damage, and yeah, first skill and I'm done. That's how the combo should be, the second skill and second skill phase. It's your true attack. After that, enemy defense will decrease so much that enemy won't be able to defend itself. And here Vexana and this Bedeng, both CC. I think I can counter, so I will try to dive in for Vexana, because mages are easy to kill, hard to defend. Okay, I got trapped. Oh my god, shit, I died. Okay, nothing, no matter, whatever it was, I'm back to it. And now second skill, then first skill, and then basic attack, and this creep is dead. My attacks are stacking, my physical attack is stacking because of nimble blade. And here enemy Dyrroth, I think I'll kill him. Yeah, I'll try to. Yes, I have did it. Yes, the right combo, second skill, second phase, first skill. Enough of the basic attack to get it afterwards, and here I got the kill. And now we are focusing on jungle again, and here is a gang going on in the jungle, so I am running behind it. And then here we got the Bedeng. Maybe we will kill him, maybe I'll not. Yeah, second skill, first skill, and here the basic attack. Nana got the kill steal, and we are running ahead of it. There is a empty Vexana here. Maybe if I dodge the CC, then I'll get it. The second skill, the second phase, the first combo, and maybe, yeah, okay, sprint got her, no one else. Okay, fine, I tried my best, but sprint got them saved. Okay, so here are the minions, I'm cleaning them up so that I'll be going top after it probably. Or just wait for the enemy to come. Here's the enemy Enzo's first skill, second skill, second phase, and maybe I'll ult. No, I'll not ult now. Okay, yeah, didn't got it. Okay, fine, we'll wait for the minions. There's no point in turret diving. Okay, again we'll be clearing the turrets until we can't even die. Yeah, here came the Bedeng ult, and I've been skipped with the second skill. Now I have to find the Hanzo body and I'm going after it. Here's the Hanzo body. I got it the second skill, second phase, and the first skill combo, basic attack, and he's done. Got the another kill. Now I'm going again for enemy. Yeah, this enemy Dyrroth, he would be dead. Yeah, here it is, double kill. Timing right, and then here is the double kill, and maybe I'll kill Vexan also. Yeah, the triple kill. I'll aim for the maniac. The sun is in the top lane. Okay, wait, this bot is following me. Let's fight it. Okay, so Vexana bot also follows the passive. So yeah, here I died because of it. And okay, there's the again resurrection. I'll go for the sun in the mid lane. Maybe I'll go for it, but first jungling, because I have to stack my physical attack up to 10 since I've been using nimble blade, so it would be beneficial for me. Now again I'm going for sun. Maybe I'll kill it, and yeah, second skill, first skill on sun. Okay, he ran away, giving this doppelgangers to me. And then again I'm going behind the sun. Okay, the wasted flicker. Yeah, sun is waiting for me, and I'm waiting for the sun. Second skill, second phase, first skill, and yeah, but basic attack combo, and the sun is dead. Same combo every time. Second skill, phase 2, first skill and basic attack, and then enemy is dead. So I'm here with the highest farm, enemy Dyrroth. I have seen him. Maybe I'll go to kill him. Vexana is first to die. They are chasing the enemy Dyrroth. Enemy Dyrroth is dead also. Okay. So the next thing I have to do is to do jungle. Jungle as much as you can, because you're a fighter, you have to overfarm the enemy. So you're a fighter, so you have to jungle as much as you can, cleaning the bottom lane, and then after that we will be going to the mid lane. And here it is. I've been in the highest farm, in the best state. I've been an abyss in hand since the red bar. And maybe I'll kill Badang. No, I'll not go after the Badang. I'll go for the Hanzo's body. Yes, I'll go for the Hanzo's body, because it has been just used his soul state. First I'll clear the minions. Probably then only I can go for the Hanzo's body. I've cleared the minions. There is a gank incoming. I have to run from here, because I'll be the one who will be grinding here. Okay, let's see what happens. I'll be taking crab. I'm utilizing my time unless the gank starts. Here the gank starts, and yeah, first kill for me from second skill, first phase. Second skill, first phase, I have been the Vexana ult. Second kill from the ult, and I still have the second phase of my second skill. Yeah, second skill refresh, second skill, second phase, and your basic attack. Okay, that was close. Got the triple kill again. Again, I'm just clearing up the minions, and I'm going for the Badang in the mid lane. Got two triple kills, no maniacs yet. Maybe missed or just got unlucky. So I'll clear up the mid. No, I'll not clear up the mid. I'm not up to that. So we'll see. I'm on 10k farm, way ahead from enemies, and I'll be finding sun. And that was a bad move. Okay, sun was waiting for me with inspire and his group doppelgangers, 3-on-1 here, and I got tied. Okay, my god. Well, no worries, maybe Zilong will also die. Okay, not worries about it. 10k farm yet, and enemy has the highest farm of 7k. We'll see what happens. And enemy Hanzo is stealing our farm, and here it is. Going ahead. Maybe I'll get enemy Hanzo, else we shouldn't be. So we will check if we can get. Yes, I can get the enemy Hanzo. Second skill, second phase. Or yes, he used the sprint, so I can't. Okay, he's in the soul state. I can't drive like this. Okay, I can kill his state, and now maybe I can turret dive, but I'm not that greedy enough. And maybe I'll jump on him again after my skills refresh, but not now. So here we got the top lane turret. And yes, I'll be jumping on Hanzo because I'm greedy. And yeah, here it is, ult, and got the kill. I'll be hunting for kills now, because I'm enough farmed so that I can take any enemies one on one except the tank. And here we have got the sun. We'll see what happens to the sun. Maybe he'll recall, or else he will be cleaning up the lanes. To be honest, Dyrroth is a assassin fighter. Not only a fighter, assassin fighter. And I told you that I'll be changing builds a lot, so you will see me changing the builds here with this Apocalypse Queen and Critical. Yeah, here I again got the free kill, or I can say I just saved the Moscow. I can see that I can't sustain enemy without some HP addition, so I will be using Wings of Apocalypse Queen later. That's some unconventional build but works fine with this Dyrroth. And yes, I'll be cleaning up the enemy jungle, and maybe I'll kill Hanzo also. Yeah, here it is. Yeah, first not even ult was required to kill the Hanzo. Again yeah, double kill, and now I'll die. Okay, Sun killed me because I was lack of skills. I was like a empty barrel of gun. I was lack of skill, lack of escape skill. I was just like a doll there, so I just got tied. Again, I've been respawned, and I'll be changing my build to Apocalypse Queen and Berserker's Fury. Blade of Despair, you shouldn't be not be changing in any circumstances, because Blade of Despair is the best item for this guy. Unless until enemy got his health below 50%, the Blade of Despair is the best thing ever, which can work fine. And yeah, here's the Hanzo. I'll kill him this time. Maybe I'll, yes, okay, didn't. Okay, so I'll be doing this one-on-one. This guy, okay, I'll do it. Yeah, because I'm overfarmed, I killed that guy. But to be honest, I'll be killing him no matter what. And here is the soul of Hanzo, which is now standing the body. Our god will try to kill it, and here he did it. He got a double kill. Okay. That was funny, that god with that Vexana horrified result was roaming everywhere. That was funny. Now we have Sun. Yeah, I'll be jumping on Sun. Sun will be throwing local gangers. Okay, that was a close call. I can go now. I have been built fully, and I'll go to the base just to recall, and then I'll be back for vengeance. First thing first, I got the blade Wings of Apocalypse Queen because I need enough lifesteal in my hard times to counter the enemy. There's a burst mage, there's a burst assassin fighter probably, and Bedang. I fear Bedang and Sun. If they go both got into me 2v1, then I would be needing Wings of Apocalypse Queen to counter them. Now I'm again eating the enemy jungle. I have been jungled enough, and now we just have to take the base, nothing else. So told you guys in my earlier videos that I'll be, yeah, here is the button kill, no ult, just second skill phase 2 and first skill and a basic attack if required. So I was telling you in my earlier videos that I will be using Wings of Apocalypse Queen according to enemy, and I have used it here because I want to sustain enough with some high HP, so I have did it here. Okay, again I'll be killing Hanzo or Bedang. Yes, I kill Bedang with second skill, second phase, enough of damage reduction, first skill, and we are done. No basic attack required. Okay, Hanzo here. Yeah, we got him. Yeah, tower diving killed Hanzo fully in turret itself, taking the damage. And look at the lifesteal when my life HP was 50% less. You look at the lifesteal I got from the ult. That was because of passive Wings of Apocalypse Queen. So I'll be jungling enough, and here the game is over. It was a good game overall, and I would be thanking Nana also, Satan. He could play with me as duo. Thank you for that. And you can look after the stats. Here they are, 24 22 4 3. That's enough of a KDA. Okay, I have been changing builds a lot, but somehow it worked, and yeah, it was good. I was experimenting with the builds, but Wings of Apocalypse Queen is a must be if you want to sustain enemies for a larger time. Okay, thank you for watching. This is KnightProwler Gaming signing up. Until the next video, do subscribe, like, share.